I love Teletubbies. To be honest, I do. It was one of my favorite shows growing up. I remember watching it on VHS and DVD. And even ABC Kids. Well, I've watched only 5 episodes because of the times I was too scared to watch it on ABC. But I will tell you lovely people a story that has changed my life. I was home alone, and my parents were out in town until 6 p.m. I was watching the current ABC Kids waiting for a reboot episode of the Teletubbies to come on. At one point, I saw a promo for a never-before-seen episode of the classic Teletubbies that never aired on ABC Kids from 2001 to 2009. I was confused, but surprised and excited to watch it. It said it would premiere at 4 p.m. At 3:30, it was almost time to watch it. I was about to sit on the couch to watch it, but I decided to make some popcorn and a drink to have with the episode. So, I microwaved some popcorn, poured myself a drink and sat on the couch with them. Before the episode started, it showed a reminder saying that the current ABC Kids will change to the old ABC Kids from 2007, 2008 and 2009. I was happy to relive my childhood TV days. It even showed the old green ABC Kids screen bug after 11 years. Now, the episode has started. The intro played normally, but the voice trumpet said something other than "Where have the Teletubbies gone?" It said,
they're coming for them.
What is coming for them? I thought to myself, but I carried on with the episode. It showed the first act of the episode. The narrator explained something appeared from far away, and what appeared was 4 fake skeletons. Skeletons? I thought, why would they put skeletons in a show for children? Moments later, Lala walked up and found the skeletons.
Ooh-oh!
She said. She examined them, and asked,
what's that?
They are skeletons.
The narrator replied. Lala picked up one of the skeletons and giggled. So, she went to get the other Teletubbies that were in the house. Lala found Tinky Winky, Dipsy and Po eating Tubby Toast in the house. She told them to find what she had found. When the Teletubbies went back to see the skeletons were standing up. The Teletubbies were confused by this. There was a pause for 6 seconds until one of the skeletons said,
hello.
The Teletubbies gasped. The skeleton that first spoke said,
no need to be afraid, little ones, I am Skelly Welly Telly.
Hello.
The Teletubbies said curiously,
we just want to play a game with you 4 little critters. You just turn around and count to 10.
The Teletubbies did what Skelly Welly Pelly asked them to do. Skelly looked at the narrator and chuckled. He and the other skeletons snuck up towards the Teletubbies, while they weren't looking, and they lunged on them and started beating them up. The Teletubbies screamed. For some reason, the screams didn't sound like their usual voices, it sounded like the actors were actually in agony. Why are they beating the Teletubbies up? What have they ever done to the skeletons?
You deserved it for being stupid little idiots. You don't deserve to live in Earth.
Skelly said angrily. Then the skeletons walked off. The baby son was shocked, and she started to cry. It didn't look like Jess Smith when she was a baby. It might have been someone else's baby. It then showed the Teletubbies lying on the ground, all bruised and dead. Lala's dead body hit me. She was decapitated, and she had a bone sticking out of her chest. I couldn't handle her corpse, so I vomited outside. As I got back inside, it showed a TV event on Dipsy's tummy screen. It showed children looking at fake skeletons in a party store. I realized this episode was about skeletons. It later showed the Tubby Bye-Bye sketch. Instead of saying time for Tubby Bye-Bye 3 times, the voice trumpet said something else.
I told you they were going to get them.
I realized that the skeletons were going to kill the Teletubbies, pretending to be good to them. The sun baby was crying the entire time. The skeletons appeared again, and they were walking home. They even sat down on the Teletubbies' graves, laughing evilly. The credits rolled with the sun baby still crying. Instead of sounding happy, the music was all sober and melancholy. The episode ended. I couldn't help but cry after what I saw. I contacted Ragdoll about the mysterious episode. They said that a psycho snuck into their studio and made that episode as the series finale. I was shocked that I asked them what happened to him after. Ann Wood said that he got arrested for traumatizing children around the world. I was like, that punk deserved a lesson. I couldn't help but cry thinking about the episode when I was asleep. I still like Teletubbies, despite what I've just seen. Never judge books by their covers, and never judge titles by their names.